Here I'm asked to solve this inequality. The nice thing about this one is that it's already in factored form. So let's go ahead and figure out the critical values. Now the critical values are going to be the zeros. So what makes this expression zero? Well, by inspection we can see, well, you know, using the zero property, if x is zero, if we plug in that, we'll get zero. If x is 2, we'll get a zero. And if x is negative 3, we'll get a 0. So those are my critical values. We have 3 of them. Now let's make a sign chart. Here, since we had a strict inequality, there was no equal here, I'm going to use open dots. Non-inclusive. So 0 is a critical value, 2 is a critical value, and negative 3. That breaks the number line up into 4 regions. So we have to test each region to see if the result is positive or negative. So let's choose x equals 3. When I plug 3 in, well, certainly I'll have that x, which is 3, positive. 3 minus 2 is positive, times a factor, 3 plus 3 is positive. So when you plug in 3, certainly you'll get a positive result. So I'm going to put a bunch of pluses there. Let's test x equals 1. When I plug in 1, I'll have a positive number. When I plug in 1 here, I'll have a negative number. And when I plug in 1 here, I have a positive number. So the result will be negative. Let's choose a value here, say negative 1. Choose any value in the interval, you should get the same plus or minus result. So let's see, negative. Plugging in negative 1 minus 2 is negative. Plugging in negative 1 plus 3 is positive. Okay, so when you multiply two negatives like that, you'll have a positive result. Okay, now let's test a value in this interval, say negative 5. Okay, so substituting that in, you'll have a negative. Negative 5 minus 2 is negative. Negative 5 plus 3 is negative. Multiplying three negatives will yield a negative result. Okay, so this is the sign chart. Now, we're going to use the sign chart to answer the question. The question is, when is this expression greater than zero? In other words, when is it positive? Well, using our sign chart, we can see the results are positive for these x values, and the results are positive also for these x values. Okay, so that's our answer shaded on a number line. Now let's convert that to interval notation. Open dot, strict inequality, we're going to use a round parentheses from negative 3 to 0, union 2 out to infinity. Okay, so this is the corresponding interval notation for infinitely many solutions that'll solve that original inequality.